performance offers, and General Motors realizes that superior to anybody. Its truck-based full-estimate Chevrolet, GMC, and Cadillac SUVs rule their particular portions, and the active Lambda 3 push hybrids, the Chevrolet Traverse, GMC Acadia, and Buick Enclave, piled on huge numbers over their long life expectancies too. Presently those hybrids are entering their second era. We've officially determined the new, littler, Acadia, while the Buick presently can't seem to make its presentation, and Chevrolet's overhauled 2018 Traverse is as yet planning for an impressive future. The new Traverse is undiminished in estimate, with a wheelbase that is 2 inches longer than that of its ancestor and an entire 8 inches longer than the new Acadia's. However, regardless, it imparts its essential engineering to the GMC. This pays profits for travelers. Chevrolet claims that the new Traverse gives more headroom and legroom to the second and third push riders. Amazing, considering that the active Traverse as of now had a standout amongst the most open lodges in its class. The payload territory recoils contrasted and the old Traverse. In spite of the fact that the new model's space behind the third line, 23 cubic feet, still beat contenders, for example, the Honda Pilot, 16 cubic feet, and the Ford Explorer, 21 cubic feet. Moreover, add up to payload space with all seats collapsed goes from 116 cubic feet down to 99 cubic feet. In spite of the fact that that figure figures out how to top the likewise huge boned Volkswagen Atlas 97 cubic feet. Chevrolet's creators have wrapped the 2018 Traverse in sheet metal that embraces a more squared-off look than its antecedent. The new front end, with a huge hexagonal grille flanked by limit headlights, reflects that of the littler 2018 Chevy Equinox Hybrid. A body shading C-column separates the side glass region for a more upright, truck-like profile, and the backside is like that of the Acadia, yet with various taillights. Under the skin, Chevrolet claims await investment funds of £351, contrasting front-wheel drive base models, which aligns the Traverse more with somewhat littler contenders, for example, the Pilot and the Toyota Highlander. On most models, GM's natural 3.6-liter V6 gives the intention compel, and a 5,000-pound torque rating, with its 305 strength and 260 pounds to foot of torque. Strangely, the bigger Chevrolet has a less capable variant of this motor than the littler Acadia, which makes 310 drive and 271 pounds to foot from its 3.6-liter. The Traverse's new RS trim level is likewise baffling, as the purportedly energetic rendition of the Traverse comes just with front-wheel drive and a turbocharged 2.0-liter four-chamber making 255 strength. The Turbo 4 has more torque than the V6, with 295 pounds to foot, yet it doesn't appear to be set to satisfy the RS model's dark trim and guaranteed racier suspension tuning with any genuine execution advantage. Both the RS and the V6 controlled trim levels, including L, LS, LT, Premier, and High Country, come standard with GM's new 9-speed programmed transaxle and a motor stop, begin framework. These updates help mileage significantly. Chevrolet gauges that front-wheel drive V6 models will gain 18.25 mpg city, interstate appraisals, while the front-drive just 4-chamber RS will get 20.23 of a mile per gallon. Regardless of whether that 2.0T roadway number appears to be low, either motor gives a major bounce over the present Traverse V6, which gets 15.22 of a mile per gallon city, parkway paying little mind to driven wheels. All-wheel drive will be discretionary on V6 models, and the best High Country variation accompanies a similar torque vectoring back hub found in the Acadia all-terrain and the Cadillac XD5. The new High Country show is likewise ready to expand the Traverse's gainfulness, while the present Traverse offers at bring down normal exchange costs than its rivals. This new top-notch display, which imparts its name to a Silverado trim level, could begin around $50,000 and will rival other completely stacked hybrids, for example, the Ford Explorer Platinum and the Honda Pilot Terrain Elite. Both 7 and 8 traveler setups will be offered, with the lower trim levels having 3 situate seats for the second and third columns and a fancier forms brandishing 2 skipper's seats in the center line. Families will welcome the fast discharge second push situate that enables simple access to the third column. In spite of the fact that Chevrolet limits the tumbling capacity to the traveler side as it were. All things being equal, the Traverse's rundown of accessible highlights is typically long and incorporates Apple CarPlay and Android Auto, a sans-hands control liftgate, GM's backseat update framework, a 360-degree camera, and dynamic well-being highlights, for example, versatile journey control and computerized crisis braking. Chevrolet won't report valuing points of interest until the point when nearer to the 2018 Traverse is at a bargain date in the not-so-distant future. However, expect the lower L, LS, and LT trim levels to stay in the $30,000 to $40,000 territory. The RF should opening in the middle of the LT and the Premier models somewhat over that, while the High Country will sit at the highest point of the lineup.